Hafidhullah Ta'ala. He's an Afghani sheikh who used to be in Medina. And I remember, you know, there were some students there, and the sheikh got a call from Kuwait. And it was from one of his old colleagues who we used to seek knowledge about. And he was giving us advice about seeking knowledge. And then he told us, he said, a difference between me and that brother, this brother is now calling me and asking me questions. It's because of inqita, because he stopped seeking knowledge. Where we once were companions in seeking knowledge together, unfortunately he stopped seeking knowledge, and he due to that he was unable to attain. And so now he asked the sheikh for fatawa and you know, advice or what have you. He asks him related to knowledge based issues because he stopped. So try to be continuous in your knowledge. Memorize these small books. Read them to students of knowledge, or, you know, that are grounded. Not just any student of knowledge, even, you know, somebody who's grounded and strong in the Arabic language who can correct you. Okay, they need to have that ability. Not all people who seek a little bit of knowledge have that ability. Another thing is, do not read many books or more than you're able to digest. Okay. Another thing is, memorize eventually in different sciences. Meaning, this is a book in this is Ajurumiya's very famous book, Metin for Nahu, for grammar, Arabic grammar. So you take one of these small books, start with Usul al-Thalatha. If you are somebody who's strong in memorization, maybe you can busy yourself with more than one metin at once. A little bit of this, a little bit of this at the time, and while you're memorizing Quran or what have you. But take what you're able to digest and really ground yourself, because that will keep with you forever. Even, unfortunately, myself, I'm not making muraja and doing what I should be doing, going back over the things, because you have to go. Knowledge, it will go with you. It will leave from you. And what keeps you fresh is going back. But once you've memorized something good, even if you've forgotten and you haven't picked it up in months or what have you, you still might have some of that. Some of these hadith that I relate are hadith that I memorized years ago and I still have them. But I might forget and make more mistakes, so I need to go back over them. The point being is, habit fillah is memorize in stages. And try to memorize. And some of the books that you can start with related to Tawheed, Usul al-Thalatha, you know, the three principles, in fiqh, umdat al-fiqh, if you can, which is in the madhab of Imam Ahmed, or whatever madhab, maybe you are in a place, or maybe you're Maliki, or maybe you're Hanafi, or what have you. Memorize a metin. The point is memorize, try your memorize, or at least read a lot, so you become familiar with the masail, the issues in fiqh. Something in hadith like umdat al-ahkam. Umdat al-ahkam, if you memorize that, you'll have dalil for all the abwab of fiqh, fiqh ibadat wa fiqh mu'amalat, you'll have evidence for that. And it's not a big metin, we have it around here. And may Allah bless us with tawfiq in memorizing it. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And also something in the Arabic language, like we mentioned, Ajrumiyya. And last but not least, and we've already emphasized this, is take the knowledge from the ulama. Take it from sound sources, those people who've studied Kitabillah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by the understanding of the fellow salaf of this ummah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with amal nafir, uskin tayyib, wa amal mutakabbilin, and forgive us of our many sins. And anything I said that was correct was from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Anything I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.